Good morning. This is Marla Dalton, Executive Director and CEO of the National Foundation for Infectious Diseases, or NFID. Joining me today for this edition of the Schaffner Report is Dr. William Schaffner, NFID Medical Director. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recently updated the recommendations regarding the use of face coverings by the general public. Citing recent studies on asymptomatic transmission, CDC is now recommending that the general public wear cloth face coverings in public settings like grocery stores and pharmacies where social distancing may be hard to maintain. Bill, we really appreciate you taking the time to talk with us today. So first, can you tell us what prompted the change in CDC guidance?
I think the major reason was that the CDC and all of us have begun to appreciate more and more that there is asymptomatic or only modestly symptomatic transmission of this virus. And if that's the case, then I may not know that I'm infected when I go to the grocery store, and you certainly don't know if your healthy appearing neighbor is. And the only way to interrupt that transmission is for all of us when on essential tasks, we go out of doors to grocery stores and the like, that we all wear some sort of face covering, whether a mask or something homemade that covers our nose or our mouths.
So that's actually a good segue to, there's a big distinction being made now between face covering and face mask. Can you tell us why the public health authorities are making this distinction?
Well, a lot of us have face masks in our home, but we don't want people to try to run out and buy new face masks because we don't want to siphon those off out of the healthcare environment, which I think all of us would agree is first priority. Now, lots of people are making homemade face masks, kind of in patterns that are available on the internet and in newspapers, and others are just wrapping our faces with shawls or scarves so that our noses and our mouths are covered. I think that's the distinction.
Thank you. So do you advise folks to wear a face covering every time they leave their house, even if they don't expect to be around other people, for example, during a solo bike ride or run?
I think you ought to have that face covering, face mask with you whenever you go out, because you never know on a sunny day going to the park for what you think is a solo run, all of a sudden you find yourself in a small crowd of like-minded citizens who've all decided to go out. But I think if you get to the park and find out that you are pretty solo or you're off on a bike all by yourself, then I think as long as you have that face mask in place when you return home, then I think you can go about your business without the face mask.
Great. So if I'm exercising with a friend, presuming we're staying at least 6 feet apart as recommended, do I still need a face covering?
You know, that's a hard question because what we would all like to communicate to everyone in the environment that we're all in this together and all doing it together. My inclination would be at this time, I'm more inclined to wear that face mask than not.
Fair enough. So how often should these homemade face coverings, whether shawls or do-it-yourself masks, how often should they be cleaned?
Well, we're not in the healthcare environment where this is a major issue because of potential contamination of the external surface of the face mask or covering. We're out in the public where we think that's much less likely. So without making a big opera out of this, I would say wash your face mask or your covering only when it gets soiled. But be careful. When you take it off and put it aside in a nice dry place, go immediately to the sink and wash your hands or use that hand sanitizer.
So lastly, the question on most people's minds now and the million-dollar question is, how long do you think these precautions will continue to be necessary?
Marla, here's my cloudy crystal ball again, trying to look to the future. Actually, the non-facetious answer is it will be some time yet, but listen to your local public health authorities because this is going to vary. We have a large and disparate country. Some places may start to get back to normal before others. And even within states, there may be differences in one city or another. So listen to those local public health authorities.
Always good advice. Is there anything else, Bill, you'd like to share with our listeners?
I just hope everyone adheres to these recommendations and stay healthy.
Thank you, Bill, and thank you for joining us for this edition of the Schaffner Report.
My pleasure.